Tall Dixie here. Today I want to tell you about the gear that I've got my sights set on for trying out next year in 2020. Probably in the early spring I'll be doing the Pinhoti Trail, and then later in the fall the TA in New Zealand. But the convenient thing about the Pinhoti is that it's located here in my home state of Alabama. So I'm thinking while I'm out there, I'll probably swap out different sets of gear and do at least a 100-mile section with each of them so I can kind of test them out and get a feel for them. And then maybe I'll use some of those things later on the TA. Let's talk about shelters. One of the shelters that I aim to try out is the Warbonnet Blackbird Hammock with the mini fly tarp. Some of y'all that remember my AT thru hike might be a little surprised to hear that I'm gonna give a hammock a go, because I started that trip and I had never been on an overnight backpacking trip, nor had I ever tried a hammock. And I went out there with a pretty rickety hammock setup. I had the E&O double nester with slap straps, a bug net that was made out of shear panels from Walmart, and a homemade tarp made out of painter's drop cloth with duct tape. So it was a whole mess. It weighed a lot, and it didn't take me long to transition to a ground dweller and go with tents, and that's really where I've been at since then. But a lot of folks said, well, Dixie really didn't give hammocking a fair shake. So I was originally gonna try out the Hennessy Hyperlite because I felt like that was a pretty complete setup that was lightweight and would be something good for a beginner. But that's not gonna be back in stock until next year, and they really couldn't tell me when. So I looked for another lightweight setup and I landed on the Warbonnet Blackbird single layer with the mini fly as a tarp. And I'm sure a lot of y'all are gonna be like, oh no, that's terrible, you should have gone with this. But that's what I've got, that's what I'm going with, and I'm pretty excited to try it out. I know y'all have suggested some different resources for learning about hammocking, and I'll definitely be checking those out, so wish me luck. The Warbonnet Blackbird single layer without suspension is 15.75 ounces. It's made out of 40 denier nylon and has a max load of 350 pounds. And then the 20 denier Sil Poly mini fly is 11.75 ounces. I'm pretty excited about giving this a go just because there was a serious learning curve for me on the Appalachian Trail, and I was familiar with tents to some extent just from car camping, but on the Pinhoti I won't be as pressured. I'll be able to take my time and enjoy learning something new, because it won't be like drinking from a fire hose and learning a million new things at one time. Another shelter I'm gonna try this next year is the Mountain Laurel Designs Pro Rain Poncho. And if you're wondering how is a rain poncho a shelter, it actually is. It doubles as both. So during the day, in the rain, you could wear it as a poncho, and then at night when you sleep, it sets up as a tarp. And I don't know, there's something intriguing to me about having a piece of gear that serves two purposes as a shelter and rain gear for 12 ounces or less. Now, I personally would not try this if I wasn't gonna be in a heavily wooded area where I feel like I can find more prime real estate for using a shelter like this. If I was gonna be hiking in predominantly exposed areas where I might get caught in a storm, and this isn't, you know, that great of a shelter to protect me from that, then I probably wouldn't take this. Now, I'm not saying this isn't something that could be taken on a thru hike depending on what trail you're doing, but I don't know, I wanna step outside of my comfort zone, because I feel like, not that I'm getting bored with backpacking, but I feel pretty proficient at the shelter that I have and my current setup. So I just wanna mix it up a little bit and try out a new skill and see if it's something that I can make comfortable enough for myself. Also, I think it'd be a good idea to get proficient with this piece of gear, because it would be a good item to have in a day pack for your 10 essentials of hiking. It's always a good idea to have rain gear and a shelter. So why not have a piece of gear that will protect me from the rain and also offer me some decent shelter, better than, you know, a trash bag or some other makeshift shelter. Another big three item that I will be testing out next year is the Onni-LiteSkin. It's a 50 liter pack made by Katabatic gear. The medium that I will probably get is 29.2 ounces and the large is 30.2 ounces. The total capacity of the pack is actually 51 liters. It has removable aluminum stays, a magnetic roll top closure, a ventilated back, large outside pockets, bungee attachments for gear, and all sorts of other desirable features. It's made from light skin fabric, which is a sheet of non-woven filaments that is a waterproof fabric up to 160 PSI. It looks like a pretty cool pack. I like that it has aluminum stays that I could remove if I wanted to and I had a more lightweight load, but for myself, knowing that I generally have a pretty heavy pack, I think that I'll leave them in, but I do like that it has that versatility, and I prefer packs that have waterproof material because they don't absorb the water and you don't have that extra water weight, and then also it's redundancy in waterproofing. So anyway, I'm looking forward to giving this a go, and if it works out well, then I might just even take this pack with me on the TA in New Zealand. Something else that I'd like to switch up a little bit in 2020 is my clothing. And one of those items that for sure I'm gonna try something different is my Puffy coat. I've been using the Mountain Hardwear Ghost Whisper and pretty much the same brand and type of clothing since my thru-hike of the Pacific Crest Trail. But I've been eyeballing the Montbell Plasma 1000 Alpine Down Parka. It's got a hood, 1000 fill power down, and it just looks really warm. The claimed weight is 8 ounces, and it's actually not the lightest down coat that they have available, but it's got the best warmth to weight ratio. And it seems pretty similar to the Ghost Whisper that I've been using, but I'm hoping that it's warmer. And since I always freeze, to me, it would be great to have a Puffy that kept me a bit warmer. I've been pretty happy with the Ghost Whisper, but I'm always up for trying something new. The only thing that I'm kind of hesitant on is the price of this Puffy coat is pretty steep. So I'm not sure that the warmth increase is gonna be worth it, but I might test it out so I can at least let some of y'all know what I think between the two of those coats. If any of y'all have tried it though, let me know your thoughts in the comments below, especially if you've also tried the Ghost Whisper. Because like I mentioned, I'm always up for something that's gonna keep me a bit warmer, especially if it's around the same weight. Now let's talk about footwear. I have been stuck on ultras and specifically the Lone Peaks since my thru hike of the Pacific Crest Trail. And that's because I had done some damage to my toenails from my shoes being too small, and I was trying to mitigate that damage with a wide toe box, which Ultra is known for. However, my toenails still turned black and fell off, and now they get ingrown. So I can't imagine going back to a narrow toe box, and I really do love the Ultras. I also like the zero drop of the Ultras, which just means that the heel is at the same level as the toe, where in most tennis shoes there's some drop from the heel to the toe. So I haven't really been willing to try to fix something that isn't broke. However, I know that footwear technology is always moving forward, and there might be something out there that's more comfortable or that I really enjoy more. And then I saw the Topo Athletics trail runners, specifically the Terraventure 2s. They do have a drop, a 3 millimeter drop from the heel to the toe, but they look pretty durable, lightweight, and they do have that wide toe box. I don't think that they're as cute as the Ultras. I do like the look of the Ultras better than the Topo Athletics, but it's not a fashion show. It's more about functionality over fashionability, if you will. So I'm definitely gonna give them a go, and I think pretty quickly my feet will tell me whether I love them or not. And if not, then I'll be testing out, and I might even test out anyway, because I love them, the Ultra Lone Peaks 4.5s that they're out with now. The only real complaint that I've had with Ultras over the year is they do seem to wear out fast, as in getting holes on the toe box area. And I know a lot of folks have an issue with the tab on the front toe kind of coming separated. So it's nothing that's really functional that becomes an issue. But when you do pay over $100 for a pair of shoes, you want them to last a while. And I can say that Ultra does have a great customer service. Anytime that I feel like the Ultras ran out before what Ultra guarantees, I've called them or contacted them and have gotten a replacement, but it's just, that's a pain to have to deal with. So if I can find something that's as comfortable and functional and works well for my foot as the Ultras, but also is a bit more durable, then I'll probably stick with that. So those are the new pieces of gear that I'll be trying out in 2020. I am going to have a new quilt. I use the 30 degree Enlightened Equipment quilt on the PCT section hikes this summer, and I loved it. So I'm thinking about just getting a warmer EE quilt for the TA, but whatever I get, I wanna go ahead and try out while I'm on the Pinhoti. I've thought about getting a different brand just to try something different, but I really did love the EE. So if you've got a quilt that you absolutely love and it is warm, because again, I'm very cold natured. Leave that in the comments below. I know that all of the gear on this list is pretty pricey, especially for folks who are just getting into backpacking and may not feel comfortable investing that amount of money into something that they're not sure that they're gonna love. So I do wanna test out a variety of budget gear, shelters, packs, etc. So if you've got any ideas, or if you've been eyeballing anything and you're not sure that you would like it, I don't mind being the guinea pig. So leave those suggestions in the comments below and I'll probably test out several different things. And I know that a lot of the budget options come from China, and folks feel like you should really be supporting the economy here in the US and these cottage companies. And I agree, and that's why a lot of my gear comes from those places. But I know that a lot of folks who may even be experienced in backpacking don't have the budget to purchase from those companies. And my goal is to get people out on the trail enjoying nature, because I feel like nature does so much for the body and the mind. And I know it's completely changed my life and my perspective. And I just want it to ruin everybody else's lives too. So anyway, thank y'all so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe before you go. And we will see y'all next time.